Nearly 8 a.m. on a cold January morning in 2007, a musician had just set up in a Washington, D.C. metro station near a trash can and some escalators. Dressed in jeans, a long-sleeve t-shirt, and a Washington Nationals baseball cap, the musician, a Caucasian male, opened his case and dropped in a few bucks to inspire others to open their wallets. Then, amidst the morning rush hour bustle, he began playing his violin. Over the next 43 minutes, the musician played six songs. Exactly 1,097 people would walk past him, but only seven stopped to take in the performance for a moment or two. 27 people gave money for a grand total of $32.17, but most of them never even broke stride. That leaves more than 1,000 people who hurried by oblivious. Many didn't even bother to glance at the musician. Neither did dozens of customers who lined up to buy lottery tickets at a nearby kiosk. You know what all these people missed? A live performance by none other than Joshua Bell, one of the world's preeminent violinists. Just days earlier, Bell had played to a standing room only crowd where just average seats cost about $100 each. The six songs he played in the subway station that January morning were some of the most beautiful, complex masterpieces ever written. Bell played them on a violin called a Strad, which had been handcrafted by world-renowned violinist Antonio Stradivari himself in 1713, the instrument alone worth well over $3.5 million. The Washington Post had arranged this performance as a social experiment, and it was amazing to see hundreds of people rushing past with nary a glance at Bell. As I reflect on the story, I realize that I too probably would have raced on by and missed one of the best violinists in the world, playing the best music in the world on the best violin in the world. Do you think you would have too? Why? Well, I think it goes beyond simply not recognizing the incognito Bell. Very few people could have, unless of course they were classical music fans. More important to consider though is this. If we're too busy to stop for just a few minutes to take in some beautiful music played by one of the world's most superb musicians, what else are we missing in our lives? I learned a great lesson about slowing down and enjoying the good things in life from Doris, my mother-in-law. I remember one Saturday afternoon when she was visiting us at our house. I mean, okay, let's be honest. She was there to visit her two grandchildren. My wife and I just happened to live in the same house as they did. Tina, my bride, was lamenting about being so busy and so tired and how frustrated and embarrassed she was that the house was a mess and she hadn't had time to vacuum or dust or anything else. When Doris, a mother of five herself, looked straight into Tina's eyes and said something I will never forget. "Leave that dust alone, honey, and go read a book to those babies, because in a blink, you will have nothing but dust." Let me encourage you today to slow down and listen to the music in your life, whether it is a virtuoso's solo or a child's laughter.